word in the book of Psalms 100. Sorry, Psalms 11. This is a very common verse that we know. Verse number 3 of Psalms. It's a verse we know. But allow me to read again. Allow me to read there. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? Everybody read with me the word. 1, 2, 3. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? And the church say, Amen. Another version talk about when the foundation are destroyed. But another version also talk about when their foundations are shaken. And these are very few words talking about, there are only three talking about foundation, destroyed, and righteous. But I want to share that when there are moments when these things happen, there are times in the life of people who are doing well, when the foundations, and the foundation talks a lot of many things, there are times when foundations are shaken. This one speaks about things that are doing well, people that are doing very well, and somehow what they have been putting their hands to hold, what they trusted, the land they are walking on, the things they are doing, there are moments that comes to shake those things. Dear brethren, it's written that those moments will surely come. And in the history of the Bible, foundations are shaken, number one, in one time, or God can be the one shaking the foundations. That the heavens and the earth shall be shaken. There are things that are called shakeable, and one day the time of shaking will come. There are things in the heavens that are also not permanent. They will be shaken. The foundation of the heaven and the earth, all of us brethren are aware, we know that God has founded the heavens and the earth. But there are more than God will also shake the foundations. If you are with me, say amen. In the history of the Bible, Satan is also having sometimes opportunity, some strength to shake the foundations. So other foundations can be shaken by Satan. Agree with me, church?
Yes.
Number 3, men have also power. They have ability to shake some foundations. Men, I'm talking about men. And when I talk about men, you will quickly think about the man, the man. But even the man, the female, somebody called a woman, have some strength and ability to change some foundation. will feel the shaking. So, I want to let you know, even as we are in this service, in this time in the history of the world, foundations are going to be shaken. They are going to shake. When we talk about foundations, we're talking about peace. Peace can be shaken. We're talking about good health. Health can be shaken. We are talking about economy. Economy can be shaken. Men who rule the world by power of leadership, leadership can be shaken. If you are with me, say amen.
Amen.
So, whatever you do, wherever you work, you need to have this understanding that time comes in the history that what you are doing, where you are working, can be shaken. What you are putting in your hand can be shaken. And I mentioned to you, God, Satan, and men can shake the earth. When we talk about the earth, we are not talking about the soil. Even the foundation of the soil can also be shaken. Sikwani mumesikia handshake inaitwa earthquake. And glory be to God. Today we have a question which I want to answer within a short time. A question that I asked. How many of us agree up to that point that foundation can be shaken? How many of us can believe we believe that foundation can be destroyed? So if we agree, the question is, if the foundation, and man of God, you when you talk about if, it is not well. It will surely be shaken. Agree with me. It is really coming. That shaking is surely coming. Hallelujah. So the question is, if the foundations are destroyed, what will the righteous do? Number one, the righteous will turn to God. I say the righteous will turn to God. And I want to let the church know, brethren, that anytime foundations are destroyed, anytime foundations are shaken, the solution, the remedy, is turning to God, because the Lord Almighty does not shake. God cannot be shaken. The reason why we turn to Him is because the Lord is firm. The Lord is firm. I don't know how to put it, but I want you to understand, He cannot be shaken. He cannot be threatened. He cannot be moved. The Lord our God is faithful, is righteous.
That's right.
When we talk about being firm, we're talking about His faithfulness. All of us, we understand that the Bible says the righteous are bold, like a lion, but the wicked run away when nobody chases them or pursues them.
Right.
So, when the Lord says, be firm, and you will see the salvation of the Lord, He's talking about, can you look the Lord. We were not yet a people. Those things we were far off. We have been called by the grace of God. And today, by His own righteousness, whom we have believed, we have been made closer to God Almighty. We are thanking God. And glory be to God. I was almost to say since I was born, but again I am not old. But even you, since you were born, you've never seen what we are seeing today. This is purely the word of the Lord. Foundation can be destroyed.
That's right.
Foundation can be shaken.
Amen. That's true.
The schools, the routine, the schools in the nation has not been open. We are now almost 1 year. And when they are going to open, I don't know in other places, but we know in some areas where we come from. Even this January, we are believing God whether we will have children, daughters who will go back to school. Many problems are there. Do you understand what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Foundations are being shaken. Listen to me, young people. Foundations are shaken. But what will the righteous do? Turning to the Lord. Number one, the righteous will turn to God because God cannot be shaken. We turn from the shaking to unshaking. We turn from the shaking to the unshaking. We turn from the things that can be destroyed to the things that are permanent.
Amen.
The things that remain. And what remains upon one is the righteousness of God.
Amen.
If it cannot be destroyed.
Forever.
He is faithful forever. When the foundations are destroyed, listen to me, we turn to the Lord who cannot be shaken, who is faithful.
Amen.
And we can call upon His faithfulness. Say with me, amen.
Amen.
Turning to the Lord, brethren, include prayer and repentance. That is turning to God. The man of God was teaching this morning and he mentioned and said, people in this country are funny. Even when the shaking is going on, some people are shaking but they are not. They don't know how where to hold. They keep on, they continue with their wicked, evil lifestyle. They cannot even repent. They cannot even comprehend and say, could this be because of my evil? They cannot imagine. They cannot even think and say, can I turn to God? They cry today, and tomorrow they are in the same place. What will be done? What will be done to tell a man, a human being who is created by God, that this time around your life is in great danger? Turn to God. What will be the great sign? Let me say this to you. What we were thinking that our churches will be full at Namari Pakuenga Watu, because the whole world is shaken because of Corona. We thought people will come to God. We thought people will repent their sin. They will go to churches. Our number has not increased. We were like this even before Corona came. Because people in the outside here cannot know that the foundations are shaken. And the only way is are you who understand that it is time to turn to God?
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
I say glory be to God.
Amen.
When foundations are shaken, God remains strong. We call him the salvation. We call him the rock of our salvation. Jesus one day talked about people who build their homes on sand, on a sandy ground, and other people putting a house on a rocky foundation. Listen to me, church. The same temptation comes to every person. That is why I'm saying there is a difference between the wicked and the righteous. And the righteous, by the wisdom of God, when foundations are shaking, when the foundations are destroyed, they know where to put their feet. They know where to put their house. You don't build on the sand, you build on the rock. That is why we call him the rock of our salvation. Where we remain despite the shaking. That is coming upon the earth. The Bible says there's a difference between the two houses. The other one will fall greatly. The other one will be very far. Hallelujah. The rock we are talking about. See where you are. We're talking about the righteousness of the Lord being the rock of our salvation. I say the righteousness of God. Putting faith in his righteousness. Putting faith in the values of God. I want to let you know, we live in a time when religious and social values are being attacked. And for us to be saved is to put our faith in God the Almighty. God the Almighty, we are looking unto him. I want to say to somebody, it is all about God.
Amen.
Eh? It is all about him. It is all about him. When, let me say, when you are not having faith in the righteousness of the Lord, you will be shaken. But I want you to see the name of God who put faith in God. It does not matter what is physically happening. It does not matter what is eating me in the physical. I look unto Jesus. My eyes are up unto him. And because of this, the righteousness of the Lord will bring faith in him, will cause me to be a woman or a man of faith so that I can be able to stand during this difficult time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
There is a man called Job. There is a lot about Job. But it is written that Job chose to be faithful to God. Say, give me Job 27, verse number 5. This is Job. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
See, you know the story of Job, brethren. All of you know Job. Job. Listen to me. From Job, the first chapter of Job, verse 1. It is talk about the man of God. That there is no man in the whole earth like him. He is a faithful man. He was a man who was God-fearing. Job was so much blessed in the first chapter that in the whole land of Uz.
Yeah? Is that the land of Uz?
See, I tell you. In the whole nation, there was no man blessed like Job. Prosper. prosperous like Job, righteous like Job, God-fearing like Job, a man who was not evil, who has ran away from evil, no man like Job. That is the production of this man. He was so blessed. Chapter 1 and 2 talk about he had plenty, sheep and goats and servants. Glory be to God. Alikuwa amebarikiwa sana huyu mzee. So much blessed. He will be called a blessing. Or he was called the blessing. How many are with me? That is the chapter, the first chapter. But all of you know, all the foundations of chapter 1, one by one, were shaken. Are we together, church? Come on. His own life, the foundation of his head, was shaken. Listen to me. The foundation of his economy, uchumi yake, was shaken. Not only is shaken, but was shaken and destroyed. Unajua unaweza kupona, unaweza kupona, unaweza kuwa shaken na ikuwe firm tena. Shaken, destroyed, and stop. Are we together, church? Are we together?
Yes.
The family foundation was shaken. Have you read, listen to me, that the cows and the sheep, including the servants, were destroyed, and only one escaped to bring a report? Because there was a time of foundation be shaken. Time of foundation be destroyed. I want you to listen that when the foundations are destroyed, what shall the righteous do? He said in verse chapter 27, verse number 5, far be it from me, and I should say, you are right, till I die. I will not put away my integrity from me. Verse 6, my righteousness I hold fast, and will not let it go. My heart shall not reproach me as long as I live. And the people of God say, amen.
Amen.
The man of God, in the midst of the shaking, in the midst of the destruction that were coming upon the foundation, these are the great words he says, far be it from me that I will speak evil from my lips. I will continue to give him glory and honor him because he's God. He says, I will maintain my integrity. I will keep my integrity. I will not allow my heart to reproach me or to lie to me. My heart to cheat me. He says, I will hold my righteousness. And the righteousness which I mentioned ahead of us is the righteousness of God. I will hold it very fast. And I will not allow that righteousness to go in the times of the shaking, in the times of the destruction of my foundation. I will keep integrity. I will hold righteousness. I will not accept my heart to cheat me or to reproach me, because I have faith in the righteousness of God.
Amen.
If you are with me, say amen.
Amen.
May the Lord give us people in the church today who will keep on waiting upon the Lord in the times of shaking.
the righteousness of God.
People who know God cannot lie. God is no man. His word is true. Amen. And he said,
glory be to God.
It's a place he said, I think it's in Job 19. Give me Job 19, 25. He said, the reason why I will keep my integrity, the reason why I will hold on the faithfulness of God, because I know that my Redeemer lives, and that the people say amen.
Amen.
I know in the midst of these challenges, my Redeemer lives. And he shall stand at last on the earth. He shall stand in that latter day upon the earth. That means I know he lives forever. His word remains forever. And one day my God shall come through. I am praying in Jesus' name. The whatever challenges you are going through, may the Lord Almighty come through even to you in this house.
Amen.
May the word of the Lord come to you in this house.
Amen.
He said, my Redeemer liveth. I know one day, the latter day, he will come upon the earth. And listen to this. Though I think
this is verse 20. This is should be 26.
And though after my skin was destroyed, his body, yet in my flesh shall I see God.
Amen.
Everybody say hallelujah.
Amen.
May you go strong in times of shaking.
Amen.
I said, may you go strong when the foundation has been destroyed.
Amen.
He said, although, it's like saying like this, although my body will be destroyed, will be eaten by the worms.
Na mnasikia bali yake kwamba the worms were eating every part of the body.
The wife looked at him and said, you better die. You cannot live. And he said to her, this is not faith in God. You have spoken without faith. A person who has faith in God cannot speak like you.
Are we together?
He said, this is not the language of a woman of faith. He said, it is finally written that the man called and he said, my Redeemer liveth, although my body is eaten and destroyed by the worms, by the same flesh, one day I will see the Lord. I will see the Lord with the same flesh. I will see God. This is man, this is somebody who understood the righteousness of God.
Amen.
Although this world is destroyed, I will yet see the Lord again.
Amen.
Come on, I encourage somebody. This time of shaking is coming to an end.
Amen.
We will see the Lord again.
Amen.
As we shall live,
amen,
we will tell people in our generation that there was a time of shaking when Corona came to Africa, when the shaking came to the whole world. We shall be there to testify what God has done. We shall say, my Redeemer liveth.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
And I mentioned to you sometime, those of you who are holding on, you will one day give a testimony. There was a time where there was shaking and the destruction of the foundation and the company of some sugar was going down. But you will not go down. You will leave. One day you will give a testimony and say, behold what the Lord has done.
Amen.
The same thing I'm saying, shaking times are with us. Children says, I went out of school for one full year. And I say, you are not going to be destroyed.
Yes.
You are not going.
in the hearing of the eye, the ear. But today, my eyes, I see you. I see you with my own eyes. He said, I will see you with this flesh. Although it is eaten by the worms, but my Redeemer with it. I know when you come, you will make me fresh again. And with my own flesh I will see you. The Bible says, this man maintains integrity. He maintains faith. His problem of sickness made him more faithful to God the more. His problem took him more closer to God. And it is finally written that in all this God did not commit a sin. He did not sin. Amen. And the last chapter, John 42, says, the Lord who liveth, who he refers my Redeemer, hallelujah, finally appeared to his life. He finally came to him. And when God came, he go direct to the world was destroyed. He go direct to the source of the destruction. And the Bible says that this man was given twice more than what he had before.
Amen.
Ah. So he was given twice more than he had before in chapter 1 and chapter 2. And he said, even the daughters were given twice. The sons were given twice. Servants were given twice. Cows, the corn was given twice. And finally, in the whole land, no fair daughters were born to men like the second blessings that God gave to God. If you are with me, say amen. Allah, he got up. And the Lord turned the captivity of Job. When he prayed for his friends, also the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Allow me to finish. But I want to say, brethren, the shaking is for a time. Number two, the shaking is for the unshakable.
Yes.
And the unshakable will fall down. But the righteous will not fall. I want to repeat, the children of God will flourish them more.
Amen.
Will be given more blessing than before. Do you remember where we were before? Before the corona came, I see ourselves going to be blessed. I'm seeing ourselves going to be double.
Amen.
And this year, the Lord says, the year of double breakthrough.
Amen.
Even before Corona came, we didn't know. But the Lord says, already, he will bless us. Double means he will give us twice much as we had before. If you are with me, say amen. We will turn to the Lord. And I want to tell you, it's the time of turning to God. And any time people turn to God, God will turn to them. I tell you the truth. Zechariah 1, verse 3. Zechariah 1, 3. Say, tell the people, turn to me, then I will turn to them. God will never come to people until people go to God. Oh. Zechariah. Lakini zimnaelewa hiyo maneno. Glory be to God. Inasema therefore say to them, thus says the Lord of hosts. Listen to me, church. I feel in my spirit that it is time to return to the Lord. The Lord is saying, return to me. Says the Lord of hosts, and I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. So, what will the righteous do? The righteous, number one, will return to God. And when
right.
When the time people come to God, God will come.
Amen.
I'm feeling God is going to come to us.
Amen.
But I want us to go fast to God. I want us to go fast to God. So we in the prayer, 5 days of prayer fasting, the beginning of September. First 5 days, the beginning of October. Because the Lord is about to come to us. If he came to Job, he will surely come to us.
That's right.
That is a confident Job. And he said, I know my Redeemer liveth. And told in this flesh, the foundation of my flesh is still shaken. The worms are eating my flesh. In the same flesh, I will see God. I declare in Jesus' name, may you see the Lord in your life. I said, may you see the Lord in your life.